I went to Tahiti to do the shoot, and the day I'm supposed to leave, the guys say, hey, you know, there's just this giant storm and it's aimed right at us, and in 2 days it's gonna be enormous. I said, okay, and so I just canceled my flight. Lo and behold, 2 days later, there was a giant swell. We were like, what is that? We didn't even think that there were waves that did that in the world. Insane, bro.
What was that?
Insane. Nothing quite like it anywhere in the planet.
At that time, the surf media was filled with footage from Teahupo'o. It was this extremely thick left tube that peeled over this really shallow reef. When the waves got over 15 feet, it was considered unrideable. Laird told me, I think that wave can be ridden much bigger, and I'm gonna go tow into it. I just went, Laird, are you out of your mind?
Laird's got to ride that wave. No one's done that. No one's ridden that wave like that before. No one's towed in or paddled into a wave that big at Teahupo'o before, anywhere near it, really.
No way. Impossible.
The water outside the Teahupo'o reef is deeper, really, than in any other surf location in the world. Swells arrive through that water. They're uninterrupted wild ocean swells. The water is moving very fast. And then suddenly, it hits the reef.
When it hits the reef, all that energy doesn't rear up, it just plunges forward.
Just goes out. Straight out, straight down, straight toward a coral reef that's now about 6 feet deep.
It was just dangerous, you know. You're part of a critical mass that's gonna waste you somehow. It could take your life away, could paralyze you for life, could ruin your body. It's the wave of heaviest consequence.
I think I've always had that attitude, lay it on the line. But the fact that I was sad, I was hurt, heightened, that attribute of laying it on the line, like I maybe laid it on the line extra. I just said, yeah, okay, get me on a wave. Like, I just didn't want to procrastinate too long and think about it. The very first wave I went for, my driver was a little apprehensive and he just turned out early and I couldn't get in. I was kind of pissed. After I saw the footage of it, I was probably glad I didn't go on that one. That might have been just the wave that just dashed me across the reef and I would have been done. I went back out. Derek gets on the ski and we go out.
We go back out and this huge set comes. I'm trying to line up my skis so that I don't die. And I'm really worried about Laird, and I look back and he's gone. He let go of the rope.
Not just frightening, it's a little bit like if you've been hypnotized by a cobra or something. Like, what do? You can't freeze, you can't run, you can't fight it, you just gotta ride it out.
At one point I'm on the wave and I'm having a little talk between the halo and the horns, and it's hey, you should jump off. Well, if I jump off, I won't make it, you know, but you better jump off and don't jump off, and, you know, back and forth. And finally, I thought, well, if I jump off, I'm not gonna make it. So I'm just gonna try to stay on, and if I get knocked off, well, I have nothing I can do about that. Finished, I was, you know, kind of overcome by emotion, because it was something that, you know, that I'd been training for my whole life and that I kind of instinctually knew was out there to be done. And I did it.